want, if you don't mind my asking?
I came in here to play!
You're such a liar. What's that in your hand?
These were... I brought the scissors in so that we can make paper airplanes together! Yay!
What are you talking about? You don't need scissors to make paper airplanes. You know what? I'll bet you were gonna cut my hair off. That's what you were gonna do, isn't it?
My goodness, you're paranoid! Now let's see. Some paper...
Hey!
All done! Now to put it together. Catch! Yay! Isn't this fun?
Ah! What the heck did you do? This is the homework I have to turn in tomorrow morning!
You mean that paper was important?
I copied this off of Nayuki's! Now how am I supposed to hand this in? Good grief.
About strawberry jam, aren't ya?
Yeah, if Mom would let me, I'd eat 3 bowls of rice with strawberry jam on it every morning.
That's kind of freaky.
Well, good morning, Makoto. You're up early today.
Oh, somebody woke me up.
You start your job at the nursery today, and I know that you wouldn't want to be late on your first day, now would you?
This is what work is like.
People who don't work don't deserve to eat, so you better work hard.
Oh, I know. I have the perfect thing that can help us celebrate Makoto's first day on the job.
I wonder what it is.
This is my special jam. I don't think I've ever brought it out for you to try, have I?
No.
Everyone's welcome to have some.
Not for me, thanks. I'm not very hungry.
Yeah, me neither.
What's that smell? Look how much he's putting on.
That stuff's illegal in some countries.
Make sure to eat up because you've got a big day ahead of you.
Okay. Here I go!
So how is it? You like it?
I wish you wouldn't look at me with those pleading eyes.
Now eat as much as you like. I've got plenty more. As a matter of fact, I think I have a whole other jar.
I wonder if Makoto's doing all right.
I'll bet she had to eat a ton of that stuff before she went to work. The poor dipwad can't say no to Aunt Akiko.
It's so cute!
Whatever, I've seen way cuter than that.
Just shut up! What the heck is wrong with you?
Whoa, what are you getting all worked up about?
I'm gonna go rub his tummy.
Wait a sec, you're super allergic to cats, remember?
Yeah, but did you see how adorable he is?
Remember when you touched that cat before, and you couldn't stop sneezing for hours?
Kid? Kid?
I'm trying to help you here, listen to me!
Oh, come here.
Well, go ahead. But don't say I didn't warn you.
Come here!
What's the matter? Aizawa wasn't mean to you again, was he?
No. I know he's mean to me a lot, but that's not it.
Oh, I bet I know what it is. Maybe you were playing with a cat this morning even though you're allergic?
Mm-hmm. Yuichi tried to stop me, but I couldn't walk away from the cuteness.
Guess he didn't try hard enough. Speaking of which, where is he anyway?
Welcome back, Yuichi.
Out here again.
Yes, I'm out here again.
If you're well enough to come out here every day, then why aren't you back in class?
I'm all right when I'm just walking around, but my doctor says that I'm not ready to go back to school just yet.
You should be resting at home. You really shouldn't come out here until you feel like you're back to 100%.
But being cooped up at home for weeks on end makes me feel worse. Do you remember the promise you made me, Yuichi?
What promise?
You said that you'd help me make an extra tall snowman, remember? It's gotta be really huge, at least 10 meters.
I remember I told you I couldn't promise it'd be close to 10 meters tall.
But I've really been looking forward to it.
Aizawa! Aren't you going to the cafeteria?
Nah, sorry, but I've got other plans.
Like what?
Jeez, it's like that guy can't sit still for 5 minutes.
And Manase's no better. Well, it is a tough situation, but luckily there's a solution. You and I'll just have to eat lunch all by...
Are you all right, Nayuki? Maybe you should go get some medicine from the nurse's office.
Right! You win! I'll be happy to go! You two are lucky I was here to help out!
So, Mai, how did it go after that? Did you know what finally come out?
Huh?
Could you, like, answer me?
No.
I see. So sometimes it doesn't come out.
What are you talking about?
Oh, just about Mai's constipation.
Oh? Oh, so should Sayuri bring some medicine?
Come on, Mai! If you don't deny it, she's gonna think that we're really talking about your clogged up stuff!
I'm fine.
You know, I'm not so sure about that!
Sayuri gets it. That was a joke.
Sayuri, it must be hard to make all this food for us every day.
Oh, it's no trouble at all. Sayuri just wakes up early to get it done.
Are you getting enough sleep?
Oh, Sayuri just goes to bed early. This is embarrassing, but Sayuri's usually asleep by 11.
11 o'clock, huh? I wish I could get to sleep that early.
So then you usually stay up pretty late at night, huh, Yuichi?
I never intend to, but this little monster living at my house keeps playing pranks on me every night.
Sounds like you're really close to your family.
Well, not exactly.
My eyes have finally stopped watering.
I hope you've learned that you should stay away from cats from now on.
Guess I can try.
Even if a cat wearing a tutu covered in bunnies shows up, you can't go off and try to pet it.
I don't know. I'm not so sure if I can control myself.
Makoto should be getting off work pretty soon. Apology accepted. Now, would you mind getting off me?
Hugo, this time it really was my fault, huh?
Unless you were expecting me to dodge a surprise attack from behind, then yeah.
I said I'm sorry.
We both look pretty ridiculous, huh?
You're right, we do.
That movie we saw yesterday was pretty good.
Hugo, I was starting to forget.
So what are you doing downtown today?
Well, there's really only one reason I ever come down here.
Dine and dash.
That's mean.
Still looking for what you lost, huh? You ever remember what it was you were looking for?
No, not yet.
I'd like to stay and help you look, but I've really got to get home early today. I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's so cold out that I was thinking about going home early myself.
Okay, then I'll see you.
Right. Have a good night, Yuichi.
I wonder if Makoto's home already. Huh? The back of that head looks so hittable, it must be her. I guess you want to take one too.
Yuichi!
Did you you want a picture, why don't you go ask Caillou? I'll bet she'd like a photo of herself with a monkey.
What makes you think I wanted to take one?
But why were you just standing there staring? I mean, it looked to me like you were pretty envious.
I was just a little curious is all. Only little babies want to do stuff like that.
My God, you really can act like a bullheaded little kid sometimes, can't you?
I am not a little kid! Look, if we're done here, I'm going home!
Sounds good to me. Let's go.
Oh, you're impossible!
Your face gets all puffy when you get mad.
Huh. Is that Amuno? Should we call her over here? See if she wants to take a picture?
If you want to...
She's leaving. She can be so unsociable.
Hey, you guys! Do you want to try this one next?
Right here!
So how was your first day working at the nursery school?
Oh, it's a total piece of cake. I just scolded them when they did something stupid and patted them on the head when they did something nice.
Can't think of you as an authority figure.
Yeah, well, I was. And I worked really hard today, too.
Hey, where do you think you're going? Come on, let's walk together.
I wouldn't be caught dead walking home with someone like you.
Hey, come back! That girl is a freak show. Oh, yeah. I was supposed to buy a notebook. Why are you sneaking around and following me?
Whatever, I'm not following you. Just so happens I have to run errands in this direction.
You're such a liar. I bet you were gonna try to pull another prank on me.
That's ridiculous. Oh, I just remembered I have to go, over here. See you later.
Didn't you say you were going the other way?
Yeah, but then I remembered I had to do something down this street first.
Just walk next to me.
Huh?
We live in the same house, for Pete's sake. It'd be weird to walk there separately, and we can talk along the way.
Oh.
So I'm starting to get that you just say, oh, when you don't know what to do.
Huh? Really?
You mean you never noticed before? Oh. That's the cat from this morning.
Hey, cut it out down there! What's with the stupid cat?
It really seems to like you. Why don't you give it a little scratch behind the ears?
Are you crazy? I've never liked cats, and I'm not gonna start now.
Man, you are the total opposite of Nayuki. Here, try holding it. It's pretty soft.
No way.
Not even if I buy you a pork bun later?
You mean it?
Yeah, you have my word.
Okay, just for a second. Huh? It's so warm.
I guess that's where it's most comfortable. You see, there's one for each of us. Our cat friend gets one, too.
Oh, they smell so good! Hey, what's your problem? You give that back to me right now! I said give it back! That's my pork bun! Just give it back and I won't be mad! I promise! Stop running away from me and give it back or I will stop
you! You can stop now. What are you doing? I mean, it's just a cat, you big ding-dong.
But it's a thief!
Oh, come on, just eat one of these instead, because I bought enough for each of us, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Your brain works just like an animal's, you know that? So what are you going to do with that cat? I'd love to take it home, but Nayuki...
I guess I don't have to worry about it anymore. I got my pork bun, so I don't need it now, do I?
That's a pretty cold-hearted thing to say. That animal really seems to like you, but you don't have any feelings for it at all.
A lot of animals just get thrown away when we don't want them anymore, don't they?
Well, I suppose there might be some people out there who think like that.
Instead of just giving it away to some random people, maybe this little guy should be returned to the wild.
Returned to the wild?
Freaking crap! What the hell?
What are you so mad about?
I never thought you were capable of something like that. That cat's not gonna be able to hold on forever, you know, and what do you think's gonna happen to it when it falls off that truck?
Oh, I'm sure it'll manage. And who who knows, maybe the truck driver will take care of it.
I've never heard something so irresponsible in my life!
Well, who says I have to be responsible for it? It's not like I asked it to like me. You're the one who made me hold it.
Idiot! Don't bother crying. It won't undo what you've done.
You know what? I don't care what you think.
Hey, Makoto!
Don't worry, honey. I'm sure Makoto will be home real soon.
She's probably hungry right now.
Don't you dare feel sorry for her! Anybody who shows such blatant disregard for another living creature really needs to take time to reflect on their actions.
But couldn't she reflect here so we'd know she's okay?
Don't worry, Nayuki. If she wants to, she'll come back. And if she gets her memory back while she's out there and goes to her real home, well, that's for the best. Would you like seconds?
No, but thanks for dinner. I think I'll go out for a bit. Even if I wanted to look for her, I don't have any idea where she'd go when she's all by herself. Now that I think of it, there's really not that much I know about her. Yo! I was wondering if I could ask you something.
Go ahead.
You remember that girl who was wearing a curtain and tried to sneak up on us the other day? The one you told me I needed to stay with and protect? She hasn't been here by any chance.
She hasn't.
I figured. I knew this was probably a long shot, but I honestly have no idea where else she might have gone.
You mean she's missing? Try Monomi Hill.
Huh?
It's the one that overlooks the city. I think she could be there.
Why would she be there? And how do you know where she might have gone?
I just have a feeling about it.
I must be a moron for coming all the way up here. But it's not like I have any other leads. So this is Monomi Hill, huh? I guess I remember it being called that.
Here. This is the last one, okay? I don't have any more allowance left. It's cold, but it's still tasty. Come here. You're so warm. I think we have a lot in common. We're both strays with nowhere to go. Let's get some sleep. I've looked everywhere to find you and now I'm exhausted. I've never been so tired.
So, she's been looking for you all this time, huh? I can't believe she actually found you. I mean, I'm surprised you're not dead after falling into the expressway. Come on, Makoto. You're gonna catch a cold. Let's go home. You're part of our family now, you know. God, that girl is loud. What's the matter with you, Makoto?
Oh dear, are you okay? You should really turn on a light when you come downstairs at night.
But how did I get back here at the house after I fell asleep?
I brought you because this is where you belong, Makoto.
Huh?
Look, as long as you can't remember anything, think of this place as your home. And remember that bad girls who run away get dragged home by force if necessary.
You mean you carried me all the way back?
That's right. He carried you all the way here from Monomi Hill.
Where's the cat?
It's up in your room, sleeping.
Oh, good.
came back.
I bet you must be hungry. Why don't we go get you something warm to eat?
Okay.
Makoto?
Huh?
Makoto, did you want some more food?
Oh, sure.
We also have a few pork buns that Yuichi bought. Just let me know and I'll be happy to reheat them for you.
And I got them just for you, so when you do eat them, try to show a little gratitude.
You bought me pork buns? Seriously?
Nah, I'm pulling your leg on that one. To tell you the truth, I stole them, but you should still be grateful.
Yuichi, Makoto, pleasant dreams to both of you.
You too. Don't fall asleep before you make it to bed now. Turned out to be another late night for me. Well, even if you despise me, you'll just have to grin and bear it, at least until you remember who your real family is.
You know what? When I was just starting to fall asleep on the hilltop, I could have sworn I heard somebody talking to me, really close to my ear.
Yeah, that was me.
So what did you say to me?
I told you to rest in peace and bid you farewell.
I wasn't dead, you big dumb piece of crap! Never mind. I'm going to bed.
Don't tell me. That means Makoto is going to... I mean, is she...